Hey YouTube, Cine Flips, and today I'm back with another video. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing a backflip tutorial, as recommended by somebody. I'll try to put your username on screen, I don't know, hopefully I'll remember. I don't know your username right off the top of my head, but somebody recommended it in my last video. So today, like I said, I'm going to be teaching you how to do a backflip. So for this video, get started, make sure you leave a like. But other than that, let's get into the video. Okay, so first of all, if you want to do a backflip on the ground, you should probably know how to do it on a trampoline. There's a big difference between doing it on the ground than doing it on the trampoline. And the trampoline is way easier than doing it on the ground. But if you don't know how to do it on the trampoline and try it on the ground, it's probably not going to work well. So make sure you know how to do it on the trampoline. Also, be prepared when you're doing it. So if you're doing it for your first time, I'd recommend to have like somebody spotting you, or like maybe like mat, flat out a soft surface to land on. Because if you're doing it first time, you might not land it first try. It's not always a one day thing. It might take you a few tries, a few weeks to learn, but you'll probably get it eventually. So I'm gonna show a few examples right now. That's one, I'll do one more. Okay, so when you do a backflip, you gotta have no fear of going backwards. It might be a little bit scary at first if you're doing it for your first time, but like once you do it once, it's really not that scary. But maybe try to do like back hand swing, or like something like this. You kind of go for your shoulder and get used to going backwards. Because a lot of people are scared to go backwards. It takes a while to get over the fear if you do have a fear of it. But so the next step would be the tuck once you're going backwards. So if you watch when I do a backflip, I kind of grab my knees, so like this. Watch how I grab my knees. You hear it, like it's like hear a little sound, but so it's two different ways that you can tuck. Well, it's actually more than two, there's tons of different ways, but I tuck in front of my knee, and then some people tuck under the leg like this, so I'll show you that's the way. I don't really like it, but yeah, it all depends on what feels best for you, which way that you like. But anyway, so it would be easier if you go to like an open gym or something and you have like an instructor spot you. That would help a lot, especially when you first learn it. So you could also do like backwards rolls and stuff like that to get like used to going backwards and stuff like that. There's also, when you start to do the flip, some people just do it standing in place and just do the flip, and then some people do it like a step back. So I normally put my right leg forward sometimes when I do the step back, and then I swing my arms down as I step back and then swing them back up as hard as I can, and that helps you go up higher and then move momentum, which also helps you rotate faster. So I'll show you it with the step back way. And then this is just the normal way, just standing still. So I can do both ways. It don't really make a difference to me. But when I first learned it, I know I did. I used to do the step back a lot. I still do it sometimes. It all depends on how I'm doing it. So yeah, swinging your arms is a big part of doing the backflip. So start with your arms above your head, and then you swing them down. As you bend your leg, you bend your knees like this, you kind of bend down. So you swing your arms down. As you're bending down at the same time, your arms go back, and they swing up as hard as you can. So practice doing that, I would definitely say that you should do, because It's a big pot of it. And then just practice jumping up. Did that a few times. Helps get the momentum, so when you do it, it hopefully will work out. Okay, so I'll show you a way that, well, I'm gonna do it right now by swinging my arms up as hard as I can. Watch how, here, I'll show you two examples. One, I'm just not gonna swing my arms up hard. So, like this. See, that was like bad rotation. You saw I didn't even make my hands touch. I barely even ran into that. So I didn't land it, I'll do it again. See, I didn't even touch. One more time. See how low I am when I do it that way? And like, see, every time I land it, so high I land it, like this. Compared to like this way I'll do it right now, I swing my arms up hard and fast. See that one, I could have over-rotated. Okay, so definitely work on swinging your arms up when you do the flip. So after that, the landing is also important sometimes. So if you land flat footed like this, just bang, it really will hurt your feet sometimes, especially if you're doing it on a hollow surface. So when I do it, I kind of land on my toes and then come back on my feet. So I don't land flat on my feet when I do it, so here's a good one. See, that time is a little bit flatter. Just practice not landing quite flat, because that will hurt your feet sometimes. Like I said, especially on a hollow surface. So, maybe definitely work on it standing still on the trampoline. And then maybe if you have like a mattress, old mattress that you don't use, take a little bit of bounce on it and then do it. Also, one more thing I just remembered is don't jump when you do a backflip on the ground. The ground is not a trampoline. It don't have springs on it. So if you jump on it, it really messes the backflip up. Just, you gotta stand still and just jump when you do it. Like, here, I'll show you. I don't even like doing it. It's kind of scary, but like, this is what you don't do. So do not do this. Jumping, it's not good. It's not a trampoline. It's just, no. Stand still and do the flip. Okay, so if you haven't saw my video I posted a few weeks ago, I taught this kid right here how to do a backflip. I'd probably watch that too, because it actually kind of shows the steps that I was teaching him. Yeah. But also,
Wait, what kind of video
are you doing? Yeah, I'm doing a tutorial on how to backflip. Yeah, I know it. Basically, I know he's still practicing it, but he can land it now. Can you want to try one?
Mm-hmm. I want to put the neck as well.
Gotta move the sticks out of the way.
Okay, sit. Okay.
We got it. Go one hole.
Okay.
So this is also like an update from the video I taught him backflip. Go check it out if you haven't saw it.
Wait, I've seen your new video.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
See, he can land it now. Yeah, but he can land it. He lands it most of the time. Also, the thing that he's working on is tucking his legs. Because he used to do like, he still does it sometimes. He does layouts like this. Tucking helps you, makes you rotate faster. That'll make it land more often. So oil.
Well, and when you're close to the ground, you might actually get closer because other people are tucking. So your feet will naturally smack the ground.
Yeah. So oil, I was saying about getting a spot. So, Jesse, can you come here? So this is what a spot is. If you don't know what it is, it's basically like I kind of help him do the flip. So I'm just gonna spot him. You don't need a spot anymore. But I just want to show you what it looks like. So,
wait, are you doing the one thing?
Yeah. This is what a spot will look like. Somebody's helping you.
A little bit better. Try it one more time. Try to get a little bit. And it might try to spin when you do it.
See, that's what a spot looks like. You see, he had heights on those ones and he landed it easily.
I probably would have. Wouldn't it be cool if I could double
on ground? But,
that would be amazing.
That would be funny. That would be cool.
That would be amazing because I don't think you ever did that. So I would just.
But as you saw, a spot definitely helped. He did it like way better backflip when I spotted him.
But the thing is, don't do it too high because that time I actually landed and then
control your foot.
I smacked my leg. I smacked my legs against the ground.
Yeah, it's especially. He said that he smacked his legs when he did that. That's what I'm talking about, like the landing, like I was saying, oil. Can't just land flat. Cause that will hurt sometimes. So, also, what was I gonna say? Oh yeah. So, I finally remembered. It took like a minute to remember, but I was gonna say, like I stated it one time. But I said control your flip. So basically, and it's. It might be a little bit confusing at first, but if you're tucking, which you should be, no one to untuck. Because if you literally just hold the tuck and do not let go, you'll like, you probably won't do a double, but you probably over-rotate, maybe land on your back, and that'll hold on the ground. So no one to untuck and come out to land on your feet.
Well, you can do it like this.
Well, not on the ground. That would hold on the ground.
Yeah.
You just did a backflip to the back.
Especially when you're on, especially when a rock's right behind you.
Yeah. If you're doing it on the grass, make sure that you clear your area. Look for rocks, sticks, anything like that you might land on. Yeah, walnuts, acorns. I said acorns. That's a trampoline. Acorns. I'm good. I want an acorn. Yeah, make sure the area is clear. Sticks and crap. So, yeah, you don't want to land on anything sharp. Make sure there's no glass on the ground. You gotta be clear. Okay, so I forgot to say one very important thing. I was in the middle of editing it, so I decided to record again to make sure I got it. So, do the flip in one motion, because there's a few different things that you have to do, but you can't just do it like all together. Well, you have to do it all together. So I'll show you what not to do. So a lot of people like do it in different parts. So you go step back, like watch. It's not, you gotta put it all together. See, you can't pause when you do the flip. You just gotta do it nice and quick. So one more time, do not do this. Do not stop, you gotta do it. One clear motion, so. Yeah, I'll show you one last example. That's a good one.
One more motion.
Okay. I think I stated most of the things. I don't really know what else to say. If there's anything that you're confused with, comment it.
Where are you today?
I know, I'm tripping. Comment it below. Can't talk.
You're a drunk today.
No.
Are you sure you're listening to
me? So make sure you write a comment and I will respond as quick as I can as soon as I see it. I'll try to help you. There's tons of tutorials too on YouTube. But hopefully this one will work out. Like this video if it helps you. If you liked what I did. Also comment if you want to see any other tutorials. I'm definitely going to be doing more in the future, but just comment which ones you want to see. And, yeah, so anyway, make sure you leave, like, comment, like I said, video ideas, flips I should do, what kind of tutorials you want to see. Plus than that, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in the next video.